So, how to start? How to activate the canvas, or in this case, the canvas board? There are so many different ways, and it's real fun to try out different things. I like to start in different ways, and in this video, I will share with you three simple ways to get started. I will use canvas boards for all three. But you can use whatever you have on hand, some like to work on canvas or on paper. Choose your favorite material. For the first one, I simply start with collage material. I like to use vintage newspaper, sewing pattern, and book pages. Don't overthink, just pick some paper and start gluing. I like to use a silicone brush to bring some the glue on the surface. And for this kind of paper, I like to use mud gel medium as adhesive. Some use white glue or something like that. I think it's good to try out different kinds of glue to find your favorite stuff. So this one is from Amsterdam. And it's a gel medium. Make sure to use enough glue to avoid air bubbles. So for this one, I will cover the whole piece with paper. Later I will add some layers of paint and ink and maybe more collage material. I like to use different papers. The color of the paper is different. The sewing pattern has very nice lines. Okay, so to get an idea how such a canvas board could look like with more layers, here is one I added paint and ink and pencil lines and scribbles with colored pencil, all to create differences and to bring in some more interest to the painting. Here you can see the paper I used had red letters on, or very bold black ones. And this is a very nice way to start your layering. So for the second one, I will start with a layer of white gesso. Gesso is great to bring in some texture. So you can scratch on it to make some marks or create some pattern using bottle caps or other leftovers. You also can add a bit marble powder to bring in extra texture. So this will create a very rough surface. Later it feels a bit like an old wall. You can paint on it or use inks, or you can add some collage material. It's the very first layer, the starting point. So let the material guide you, respond to it, bring in more material and layers and have fun. This will lead you to more ideas. On this one, I used a lot of texture, as you can see here and here. I scratched on it and a lot of layers and textures with gesso, paint, inks, drawing material, graphite, pigment sticks. It's not finished yet, but it's a good example how you can use physical texture for your work. So for this one, I started with black gesso. You can use a brayer to spread the gesso or a squeegee, or use your brushes. Every tool brings in its own marks. So vary your tools to find your favorites. When the gesso has dried, you can add some collage material, vintage book pages like this one. Or vintage newspaper. Looks very great on the black background. I try to create some interesting shapes with the collage material. But this is more like a play then that I would think about too hard. The silicone brush is great to remove all the air bubbles. So here is a bit of a vintage sewing pattern. Make sure to add enough glue. I like all these lines, thick ones and thinner ones. This is a piece of drawing paper where I added a bit acrylic paint to create interesting texture. I always try to use all my stuff that's laying around here in my studio. So for me, this is really great to use those scraps for layers in my paintings. I really like differences, even if this is a layer that will disappear under layer of paint. So I think it's great to think about how to add interest to your page on every single layer. It's very interesting how different the collage material looks on a black background layer. So have some fun with your tools and materials and start creating today. Thanks for watching.